No, I was at the institute yesterday. There was a letter which has come from the INB ministry, which said that they are willing for a discussion with the right people and about this, you know. So what the government wants is that, you know, finish the strike and we'll find a solution for this. That is what they want. And I want to stress, and just like the student body people said, that they are not saying that we want to choose somebody else and so on. You know, it is just that we want something. The students are not, like I said, fighting for themselves. They're not fighting for that 2 years of what was left of their courses. They are saying, in the larger sense, find somebody who's a fitting person, who has a vision for the media and for cinema, and somebody who can inspire and connect with the student community at large. It's not just this batch, you know, that's all.
You know, sir, I was really confused when I hear different people from MPI saying, in a sense, different things. There were some who were of the mind that the entire mechanism needs to change because government will change tomorrow. There'll be a new government and there'll be a new appointee. So is the fight for the mechanism, or as of now it's just remaining or focusing on the appointment of this gentleman who is probably not fitting the caliber?
See, it's a fight for the kind of procedure. Yeah, there is. It's a fight for. I don't know the process myself. Ki who were the people who chose, and what is the? I don't know it personally, you know, because I'm not really involved in this. I'm a filmmaker. It's just that. Because we have been there for a long time, and sometimes what happens is we just need somebody who is going to be a force we are able to go with and help us in that sense. You know, here it was something that was suddenly it just came, some name came up, and there was a bit of a, you know, everybody thought it was like a surprising choice, so there was this triggered that.
The request is also for some sort of transparency to end something like this in the future.
Definitely there should be transparency, and I mean, everybody should feel happy when somebody is appointed.
Shriram sir, but the infrastructure provided to the students in FTI has always been in always brought up, not just in front of the media, but within the entire fraternity. Is that something that you are looking to address?
See, there will be lots of things about infrastructure, syllabus and so on, you know. You have to come that side. Ask again.
The issue of infrastructure has always been on the top of the priority, especially the fraternity. Is that something that needs to be addressed, that will be addressed as well? And that's something, as an alumni, is that something that you would like the government to look at also, instead of looking at all of this, the rest of it?
No, there are processes in place for that. There is an academic council, there's a governing council and so on. It's just that it all starts from the top, you know, the head of the governing council. Of course, there will be problems. There will continue to be all kinds of infrastructural problems and, things on syllabus revisions and so on, you know. Those things will continue in any case. But I'm saying these are decided by who? Not just the students. It's decided by the academic council and ratified, like it was told, like by the governing council. That's why the students are saying, get somebody who has a vision for the place.
Mr. Raghavan, you are also a filmmaker. The Censor Board is one important place for filmmakers. Do you think the appointment of Velad Velani should also be questioned?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying the industry met Mr. Rathore, and he listened to everybody, and he said, okay, if you have any problems with your films, you continue and you appeal to the, and so on, you know. So I don't know. I mean, I'm saying that's on a larger level with the entire film industry. And personally, when I had my experience with the CBFC for my film, my recent film was good. You know, I had no issue with anything like that. You know, so it is not here about, it's not about questioning individuals here. That's the main thing. You know, it's not about why is this person there. We're not saying put that person there, and we're not looking for friends in the place. You know, we're looking for somebody who's right and who will, you know, understand the overall jazz. You know?
Thank you so much for talking.
Thank you.
I'd like to start in another 5 minutes, so if I can request my friends outside to come in now. said. There are chairs that say,
Everyone will express their opinion. It's an open for all. Let's just discuss it like we some word censored. But so let's begin. Apart from that, a few of us met yesterday, including Anil Mehta sir, and in consensus with many senior members, we've written a letter which is a consolidated version of what we've been talking about. We'll read that and see if we can we can all reach a consensus by the end of this meeting. So since it's a very...
is extremely concerned as a current in passing as FGIR. The ongoing strike has highlighted some very fundamental issues faced by not just FGIR, but the other institutions of higher learning in the country. Regarding the current situation, we would like to express our concern. One, undermining autonomy through political high-handedness. The declaration of FGIR as an institute of national importance was seen as a continuation of a long-term negotiation with the IMD ministry over the past few decades or so. Mr. Jaitley's announcement on the heels of the assurance given by Mr. Jawdekar, the then IMD minister, had raised hope of strengthening and reinforcing FGIR's autonomy. This will help in correcting the mistakes of the past, which included routine political appointees in the various constitutional bodies. However, the proposed appointment of FGIR Society leaves us with grave doubts about the ministry's outlook towards granting real autonomy to the institute. The decision seems to take back.
What shall I ask now? भगवान ने मिला ये छोड़ी जो 2004 एडिटिंग टर्म है. पहली बात तो मोदी हो गांधी हो हमको कोई रंग नहीं चाहिए, ना हरा चाहिए ना पीला चाहिए ना धोखा चाहिए. अगर आप इस बात पे ला भी रहे हैं तो प्लीज मत करिए डिस्कस, क्योंकि हम ये लड़ाई यहां से नहीं लड़ रहे हैं. मतलब हमने भी स्ट्राइक की थी, हमारे बैच में हमारे जनरल सेक्रेटरी वहां बैठे हुए हैं अभिजय मजूमदार, और हमने उससे बोर्ड भी लगाया कि कुछ बात करो. पहली बात कोई कलर नहीं चाहिए, मोदी सरकार झुकेगी. अगर इसकी जगह पे मैं कह रहा हूँ ओबामा भी होता तो भी डिस्कशन यही होता, समझ रहा कि हमारे जो चेयरमैन. अब जैसे अगर मैं आपसे बोलूं कि मैंने बचपन में बड़ी लड़ाइयां लड़ी, कॉलोनी में बड़े लोगों को मारा, लेकिन मैं आर्मी का जनरल बनना चाहता हूं, क्या मेरा पेट देखकर जवान रहने जाएगा? मैंने बहुत लड़ाइयां लड़ी हैं और मिला बात कहूं तो आदमी लाल जूता तो करते रहते थे. पर क्या आपको लगता है कि मेरा मोटापा देखकर एक भी जवान फायर करना चाहेगा? नहीं करेगा. हम इंस्पायर नहीं होते तुमसे, तुमको चेयरमैन बना दें जो बना दें, हम इंस्पायर नहीं होते हैं, हम नहीं काम करेंगे. क्यों? क्योंकि तुमसे नहीं आती, हमको वाइब नहीं मिलती है. लेकिन उससे बड़ी बात है कि हम अपने माँ बाप और वतन छुप नहीं सकते हैं, खत्म. उसके बावजूद करियर भी लगते अपने माँ बाप से. आपको पत्रकारिता में आपके बाप ने कभी नहीं भेजा होगा, लिख के लू श्रीवास्तव का नहीं भेजा. सुन लो, मैं तो जवाब दे रहा हूँ, सुन लो, सुन तो लीजिए. नहीं सुन, नहीं पसंद नहीं है, बातें ऐसी शुरू होती है. समाज की बात कर रहा हूँ मैं, दुनिया भाग की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ. अगर आप माँ बाप नहीं बदल पाए लेकिन आपने अपने मन का करियर चुना, खासकर लड़की से प्यार होगा तो लड़ाई करोगे कि मुझे प्यार हो गया, ये हमारा प्यार है, समझे? तुमको 67% ये हमारा प्यार, हम इसका कुछ भी करेंगे, ठीक है? हम सब बिजी हैं. और अगर आपको ऐसे अनुमान करा दूं कि यहाँ इस समय जितने मैन आवर खर्च हो रहे हैं, ये कुछ नहीं तो 20-25 करोड़ रुपए के सब मैन आवर खर्च हो चुके हैं, जितने लोग यहाँ बैठे हैं, फिर भी यहाँ बैठे तुम्हें पता है क्योंकि प्यार है हमारा. अगर 67 नहीं 100% गवर्नमेंट भी मोदी चुने, गांधी चुने, लड़ाई उसकी लड़ी नहीं रहे. मुझे ऑब्जेक्शन है जो योगी आदित्य यादव आपने बोल रहे हैं कि मुझे नहीं चाहिए आपका स्टेटमेंट. हमारे बहुत लोग बोल रहे हैं हम यहाँ से लड़ाई लड़ लेंगे, ठीक है? उसके पॉलिटिकल कलर मत दीजिए, नहीं चाहिए कोई ना, सीधी सी बात.
आपने मोदी सरकार बोला तो मोदी सरकार आई डू नॉट एक्सेप्ट लाइक दैट. अच्छा, ये सरकार हमारा है क्योंकि ये डेमोक्रेसी हम लोगों ने चुना है, राइट? लाइक उसने कहा कि माँ बाप कुछ चुन नहीं सकते, तो भी फैमिली में कोई आएगा तो हम सबने चुना है. ऑफकोर्स कुछ लोग नाखुश है, कुछ लोग खुश भी है, लेकिन डेमोक्रेसी में यही होना है. सो हमें क्या चाहिए कि वी हैव टू कि गलतियां जो लगते हैं गलत हो गई है या सही नहीं है या कुछ नहीं है तो वी हैव टू हैव अ डायलॉग एंड सॉर्ट इट आउट. इट्स ओनली वे डायलॉग करना है बस और बातचीत को समझाना है कि वो समझ रहे वो ये नहीं है या कुछ और चीज है वो समझ नहीं पा रहे तो समझाना जरूरी है और तो ही सुधार आएगा ना. Students have already asked for a dialogue and they have agreed to a dialogue. मुझे लगता है I feel graffiti also should get into the thing and be part of the dialogue. That will help.